Only because I watched those old codgers debate last night. And you know what it's really like? There's like these two, there's like mini debates going on inside of the Republican Party debates. It's sort of like they split off and they've decided who they're going to take on. Thompson, he's going to take on Huckabee. And McCain's going for Mitt. Yay! So they have a strategy. And you know, Rudy's strategy is the one state strategy, which apparently is Bush's strategy in 2000 and 2004. Pick a state and rig the elections. So Rudy is just banking everything on Florida. And the sickest thing about Rudy's campaign in Florida, there's two things. One, I think everybody's now heard, he's asking his staff to go without pay. Something the people here at Air America just don't understand. How could that be? Well, I'll tell you what the difference is. Rudy Giuliani has $7 to $12 million cash on hand, and he's asking his staffers to go without pay. Now, if he's got $7 to $12 million in cash on hand, and he's asking his staffers to work without pay, this is not a man you want in charge of the federal budget. Do you understand me? I hope you do. I mean, it's just so bizarre. You know, why can't he do what he did when he was mayor of New York City? I don't understand. Why can't he just, you know, like, pay for his commercials and charge it to the New York City Loft Board? That's what he did here when he wanted to pay for his mistress's dog walker. I don't understand why he just doesn't, pay for his ads in Orlando through the procurement department, who gets him a girl, pays for it, and, will buy the ads. I mean, this is just the nastiest bit of business I can. It's unbelievable. Didn't Giuliani Partners make millions and millions and millions of dollars off of their post 9/11 consulting? Why doesn't he just go into his own freaking pocket if he wants? I mean, it's what Mitt does. Mitt wakes up and looks in the mirror, and that's his fundraiser. That's how he does it. I mean, it's unbelievable. Did he spend every dime he made off of doing business with terrorists in the United Arab Emirates on hookers and blow? Is that what, I don't know. I'm not sure. Maybe he's been paying Bernie Kerik's defense bills. I don't know where all the money went. But I just think look, if Jay Leno and Jimmy Kimmel can pay their staff out of their own pocket, why can't Rudy Giuliani? That's all. That's all I'm saying. Why do you have to ask people to work for free when you got $12 million in the bank? How are you going to run the federal government when it's got a $1 trillion deficit if you can't manage a plus of $7 to $12 million? It's the one state strategy. I'll just rig Florida or something like that. And Bush did, Florida and Ohio. I don't know. I think the whole candidacy of Rudy Giuliani is a joke. And last night, did anybody see the Republican debate last night? Anybody? Anybody? It was me and Eric. Should get married already and call it a day. It's just me and him. We're the ones that do this stuff. Rudy had nothing to say. You know why? Because last night he never once said 9/11. Do you know why last night he never once said 9/11? No, not because exploiting the deaths of 3,000 of his own New York citizens is a disgusting, heinous way to become the president of the United States. No. He did it because 9 plus 11 equaled fourth place for him in the early state primaries. That's why. Math's not adding up. Money's not adding up. The 9 plus 11 equals 4. It's not good for him. It's like numerology of some very weird sort. I don't know. So he really said nothing last night. I mean, it's an amazing thing to watch him now. Apparently, the truth was that, Rudy Giuliani, if you took away the words 9 and 11... and September, if you took those out of his vocabulary, the truth really was he had nothing to say. And that's what happened last night. It's what we all suspected was true about Rudy, that if he can't talk about 9/11, he has nothing to say. So apparently 9/11 is oh so 2001 for him now, because he didn't mention it all. But I mean, when you think about it, the election is going to happen 7 years after 9/11. 7 years after 9/11, 9/11, 2001. Now, using that fear card, this is like, running for president in 1948 and invoking Pearl Harbor. It's just so stupid. It's an amazing thing. So he had nothing to say. So he didn't mention 9/11, but guess what he did mention 13 times last night? Anybody? Anybody? Ronald Reagan, yes, of course, his favorite corpse. He loves corpses, that's why 9/11. He's been running on the bodies of 3,000 dead people. So why am I surprised that he would stand on top of Ronald Reagan's corpse and, you know, invoke him 13 times? So I don't know what it is with and the Republicans, you know how many times they mentioned Ronald Reagan? I'm telling you, they are so terrified of losing, and their best years are so behind them. And, of course, by the best years, I refer to the Clinton years. Those were the best years for Republicans. No, the Ronald Reagan years, of course. And so they invoked Ronald Reagan's name 34 freaking times. I thought I was watching archival footage of Ronald Reagan's funeral. That's how many times they said Ronald Reagan last night. I mean, it's unbelievable. If they invoked Ronald Reagan just like one more time or two more times, I think that, you know, Ronald Reagan would have suddenly appeared. Right? See, Ms. Hipple got that feeling. It was more like a seance than it was a debate, which was really a bunch of mini debates within a debate, because I told you they're factioned up and they're all factioned up. It is the weirdest thing to watch them flail about like that. I mean, it's fun, yes, for me. I enjoy. But if you're a Republican, these are not good days for you. I mean, you know, you got Rudy Giuliani trying to scare you by, you know, trying to raise Ronald Reagan's corpse like Chiller Theater Hand out of the little grave. You know, it's like, woo, boo, I can't use 9/11, but I could use this corpse. Ooh, here, Ronald. And, you know, McCain's hoping he'll appear because, you know, if Ronald Reagan stood next to John McCain, John McCain, by comparison, would look young. So, you know, I don't know. It was just the weirdest debate ever. It was really like a seance. I mean, or 1988. Pick your poison there. Just amazing. You know, and I think the Republicans would love to skip over everything that happened after Reagan's presidency. Everything that happened, you know, except for the Clinton years. They'd like to, like, fast forward to that. And then they'd like to forget the presidencies of both Bushes. Oh, and, you know, Fred Thompson showed up last night. I don't know, maybe the director told him, hey, Fred, this one's a take. I don't know. He actually showed up and was a little feisty last night. You know, he was doing his own version of what they did with Ronald Reagan and Fred rose from the grave. I mean, it was really very seancey last night. But, you know, if you did miss it and you're a Democrat, you missed a good time. It was a sure thing. Good bet. Yeah, there was one other very weird thing about Rudy Giuliani's campaign in Florida. I wonder if anybody knows what it is. I think the people in Florida do. But I wonder if anybody else knows how strange this man is. But then we'll spend like two more minutes on it. And then I bring good news for Kerry supporters from my friend Brent Budowski, who wrote this great piece about Edwards and his viability. I think you'll be really heartened to hear what, you know, an Inside the Beltway guy has to say about the Edwards candidacy and that all's not lost there. And then there's this great piece that Gary Hart wrote going back to the mid-80s and the kinds of elections that, you know, we had when Ronald Reagan kept winning. And why Ronald Reagan kept winning. And it really good. And news about Bloomberg and, you know, just a bunch of really fun stuff today, I think, you know. Oh, and it's the anniversary of the surge. Not my surge, no, because he is working right now. But the one in Iraq, no, not working. 17 after.
You're listening to The Randy Rhoads Show. So bright, you gotta wear shades.
You gonna ask that question with shades on?
This is Air America Radio.